Hello class 12, this is your chemistry class and today's class we are going to discuss about nitrogen containing compounds. So let's start the class. So first we will start from preparation of alkyl cyanides. Cyanides belong to the compounds that is nitrogen containing compounds. So preparation of alkyl cyanides. The first method for preparation of alkyl cyanide is the reaction between alkyl halides with potassium cyanide. Reaction between alkyl halides and potassium cyanide. So any alkyl halide plus KCN. Alkyl halide plus potassium cyanide in presence of any alcoholic solution. Alcoholic solution. We have to heat the mixture and then we will get alkyl cyanide plus potassium halide, K halide. Right. So this is the general method for the preparation of the first nitrogen containing compound, that is alkyl cyanides. So if we are trying to prepare the ethyl cyanide, suppose you are trying to prepare ethyl cyanide, then what will you take? Alkyl halide. The alkyl cyanide you are trying to prepare, the corresponding alkyl halide you have to take. Okay, so if you are trying to prepare the alkyl cyanide, that means ethyl cyanide, the so corresponding alkyl halide, that means ethyl halide you have to take. Okay, so alkyl halide means here you will take ethyl halide. Okay, so C2H5Br, ethyl bromide. Ethyl bromide reacting with potassium cyanide in alcoholic solution. The best alcoholic medium here used is ethanolic medium. Okay, ethanol is the best organic solvent we use for the synthesis purpose. So ethanol, take ethanol as solvent, alcoholic solution, and you will get C2H5CN plus KBr. The general method for preparation of alkyl cyanide. And remember that this process is only for the preparation of alkyl cyanide, not for aryl. Okay, aryl cyanide you cannot prepare in this method. There are different methods for the preparation of aryl cyanides. Okay, different methods exist for the preparation of aryl cyanide. So this particular method, that is reaction with potassium cyanide in alcoholic medium, is particularly for alkyl cyanide preparation. So next is that, what is the mechanism for this particular reaction? As you have learned about SN1 reaction, SN2 reaction, this particular reaction follows SN2 path. Okay, SN2 path is followed by this particular reaction. So what happens here? CH3, CH2, Br. This is the ethyl halide. And what happens in case of SN2 reaction? The main characteristics of SN2 reaction is the backside attack by the nucleophile. So nucleophile here will attack the ethyl halide from backside, and departure of the leaving group bromine will happen. So remember one thing here, that when you are considering any alkyl halide, take that halide portion which one is best leaving group. Okay, generally bromides and iodides, also chlorides. Chlorides, bromides and iodides you consider as good leaving group. So if the reaction is going through SN2 mechanism, That means the corresponding alkyl halide or ethyl halide should have that particular halide, which one is very good living group, chloride, bromide or iodide. Fluoride we should not consider because fluoride is very bad living group. Okay, so bromides, chlorides and iodides you consider in the halide section. So backside attack and it will produce CH3CH2CN cyanide, and Br minus is departed here as living group and combines with potassium to produce potassium bromide. So the question is that which mechanism is followed by this particular preparatory method for the preparation of alkyl cyanide, that is SN2 reaction, substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. Next preparation is from acid amide. This preparation is from alkyl halides for the preparation of alkyl cyanides, and next is from acid amides. From acid amides. So consider any acid amide. Acetamide. Okay. So when you heat the acetamide in presence of phosphorus pentoxide, heating in presence of phosphorus pentoxide, what is the property of phosphorus pentoxide? Phosphorus pentoxide acts as a very good dehydrating agent. Phosphorus pentoxide acts as a very good dehydrating agent, just like concentrated H2SO4. You must have seen in the preparation of alkene section that from alcohols we can prepare alkenes, and in that part we can use concentrated H2SO4 as a dehydrating agent, and we can also use phosphorus pentoxide as a dehydrating agent. So both have the same property of dehydration, dehydrating agent. So here also in presence of phosphorus pentoxide, dehydration will happen. That means water molecule will be eliminated. So water molecule gets eliminated. And what happens? So if H2O is eliminated here, then what is remaining? CN, right? Now you have to fulfill the valency. So to fulfill the valency, you will add two extra bonds here. Then the carbon atom valence is fulfilled now. So, and also for nitrogen, so it is cyanide. So the dehydration of acid amides in presence of phosphorus pentoxide will give the alkyl cyanides. And you can also consider thionyl chloride in place of phosphorus pentoxide. Thionyl chloride will do the same kind of reaction as that of phosphorus pentoxide. Thionyl chloride in place of phosphorus pentoxide you can consider. Next is from ammonium salts of carboxylic acid. Next preparation is from ammonium salts of carboxylic acids. From ammonium salts of carboxylic acids. So take any carboxylic acid, RCOOH, acetic acid, ethanoic acid, anyone you consider. So how can you prepare ammonium salt from the corresponding acid? How can you prepare ammonium salt from the corresponding acid? By heating with ammonia. Simple, by heating with ammonia, you can prepare the corresponding ammonium salt, RC(OONH4). And when you heat this ammonium salt in presence of, again, phosphorus pentoxide, okay? You heat this ammonium salt in presence of phosphorus pentoxide, a very good dehydrating agent. Then again, departure of water molecule will happen and you will get RC(NN). And here, the two water molecules will be eliminated. So, we can prepare the ammonium salt from the corresponding acid by heating with ammonia. And when the corresponding ammonium acetate, or the corresponding ammonium salt of the acid, is heated in presence of a good dehydrating agent like phosphorus pentoxide. Here from the ammonium salt, two water molecules will be eliminated and you will get the corresponding alkyl cyanide. So these are three preparatory methods for the nitrogen containing compounds, simple alkyl cyanides. Remaining methods we will discuss in the next class.